Oh shit.
I was just trying to catch a Snorlax. It's that time of year again, folks. The time when nerds of all shapes and fandoms flock to San Diego to quench their thirst for exclusives, sneak peeks, and the validation of knowing that all the shit we were bullied for in high school is finally cool. I'll be at Comic-Con doing my regularly scheduled geek hosting, but before I head down to that fart-filled convention center, here are the most metal comic book characters you may or may not have heard of. All right, this is sort of an obvious one, but in my opinion, Hellboy does not get enough love. I mean, what's more metal than a demon fighting magical Nazis? Also, he basically has a stone sledgehammer as a right arm. Atrocitus. Oh, you know, just a guy who was one of the sole survivors of the attack on his home, Space Sector 666. Atrocitus also became one of the first Red Lanterns by baptizing the power rings and batteries with the blood of his enemies and harnessing the power of rage. Okay, so most Norse gods in comic book canon pretty much get a free pass for being metal, but Hela might even win against the mighty Thor. The goddess of death has slain the god of thunder and even given Odin a serious run for his money as she tries to take over Valhalla. And just look at that costume. Ugh. Okay, take the image of Nick Cage as Ghost Rider and just forget that for a second, because he literally is a badass biker dude who made a pact with Mephisto, who is basically the devil, in order to save his father figure. Aww. Plus, his bike is powered by Mystic Hellfire. Solomon Grundy is a complete badass, and if the fact that he is a reanimated corpse from a place called Slaughter Swamp doesn't scream death metal to you, maybe the fact that when he was a kid he was buried alive every year on his birthday will do it for you. Now, it was super hard to narrow it down to the five most metal comic book characters. You've got Thanos, Valkyrie, Thor, Negasonic Teenage Warhead, Raven, Judge Dredd, and so many more. Comics are totally metal, you guys. But what I really wanted to do is recommend some comics that I've been enjoying right now that I think will match your taste in music. If you're into pagan occult horror, there's basically no better you can do than Harrow County. Gorgeously illustrated by Tyler Cook, Cullen Bunn weaves a very spooky story about a young girl who realizes she's the reincarnation of an ancient witch and is now responsible for all the ghoulies in the surrounding forest. But that's only the beginning. While you're reading, I'd pair Harrow County with something doomy and atmospheric like The Last Winter by Wintercolt. Listen, I know it's July, but I fucking love Christmas, and I also fucking love Grant Morrison. And lucky me, because both of those things have been combined. Klaus is the mayhemic backstory of Jolly Saint Nick as he's never been seen before. It's funny, it's cool, it's everything you'd expect from Morrison. The obvious metal pairing? Holiday metal, like Christmas Eve and other stories by the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Oh my god, this comic. Okay, Rumble is about a sort of nerdy choir dude who works at a bar and is thrust into a friendship with an ancient warrior demigod whose host body is a scarecrow. The art, courtesy of James Herron and Dave Stewart, has incredible movement and energy and fuels an ultimately heartwarming but still very badass story by John Arcudi. For this one, I'd settle in with something fun and folky like Twilight of the Thunder God by Amon Amarth. Robert Venditti's current run of the Eternal Warrior saga, Wrath of the Eternal Warrior, has been my introduction to the series, and it's absolutely fantastic. Gilad is an immortal warrior who's packing like a millennia of fighting skills. He has to travel through time and space in order to defeat gods and demons, but the story manages to be just as introspective as it is bloody. Put on some dark and slow metal like The Crash and the Draw by Minsk for this one. Andrew McLean's formerly self-published comic Headlopper was picked up by Image last year as a quarterly comic, so you really don't have to do a ton of catching up if you want to read it. It's about a badass Viking named Norgal and nicknamed Headlopper because, well, he chops off a lot of heads. He even has the dismembered head of a witch as his sidekick. It's, you get it. My metal pairing for Headlopper is some furious black folk metal like 1184 from Windir. Prophet has been running since 1992, but it's the current run written by Brandon Graham that's really worth checking out. It's about a World War II era super soldier, kind of like Bucky except way cooler, and he goes to space, he fights aliens, and it boasts a rotating roster of artists including some of my favorites, Malachi Ward and Pharrell Dalrymple. Get something sci-fi for this one, like a little Terminal Redux by Vector. The Goon falls into my list of favorite comics of all time, and with good reason. Eric Powell manages to make a story of 1930s thugs fighting monsters and zombies just as compelling and sad and sometimes actually scary as it is absolutely crude and hilarious. His incredible art is just icing on the cake. And bonus, there's actually a Goon Metalocalypse crossover issue that's definitely worth checking out if you can get your hands on it. Oh, and Eric Powell just started self-publishing again with a new title called Hillbilly that looks really rad. You'll need some spooky fun metal like Graveyard by Psy while reading this one. So that's our show. Let me know what comics you've been reading and what metal bands you would pair them with. If you're down in San Diego for Comic-Con, tweet at me. I'd love to say hi to you. I'm Whitney Moore. Thanks for watching.